Nice one.
Thanks.
Right. Okay.
Is it working, Kim? Is it?
do we intro this?
Funny intro.
Hello and welcome to Daisy Chat Films.
Yeah, work on that. Work that one out.
I don't know. Well, we was going to use Through the Grapevine, weren't we? But
I like Through the Daisy Chain, but
no, because that's just a bit boring. They won't get it.
Yeah, well, we will.
Yeah, but it's not for us, is it?
Yeah,
But Through the Grapevine's taken, and Through the Daisy Chain's boring.
So we ain't got a name, basically.
By the time it comes, out, it will have a name. So we'll just sound stupid, won't we?
Yeah, true.
Right. So films. They're good, aren't they?
Wonderful things.
Yeah.
Good this.
Well, that's good. I'll see you next time. Well, you wanted to say something, didn't you? You wanted to start?
Not really.
You wanted to say something.
Got anything to say, really. I thought we could do an overall summary of films.
Right, so we've been planning this for ages.
Yeah.
Got all the way here, and you had nothing to say.
Not really. We've planned it.
Okay.
I saw Shining yesterday.
Shining?
The Shining, yes. You seen The Shining?
I haven't seen The Shining. I haven't seen a lot of things.
I know, I realise.
But you haven't seen a lot of things either.
I've seen a lot of things.
No, but you
I've
haven't
seen...
I've
seen more things than you have, but...
Yeah, but you haven't seen a lot of things I've seen, and I haven't seen a lot of things you've seen.
This is why we're doing this podcast.
That's exactly why we're doing this podcast. how it's going to work is that I'm more of the millennial, you know, like the new age kid.
I would agree.
Who hasn't got a fucking clue. I mean, I'm older than you, and yet...
What, a year?
Yeah. I'm still old. That makes you older.
Yeah, but not like... You say like, well, I'm older, like stroking your beard or something, you know?
Pushing up my spectacles.
Because of the war. Yeah.
Right, anyways, the point is I'm older.
Moving on, yeah.
Right? Basically, I'm the new age kid. I've been there, done that, right?
Right. So.
No, but I mean is I'm more into more kiddie stuff, I suppose, aren't I? Or just like... I'm more about the more recent stuff.
You don't see nothing before.
Yeah, whereas you are...
96, probably.
Yeah, anyways, point is...
Right, yeah.
I wasn't born then. Thank you.
Right.
No, you're more about the more classic shit, the better stuff, the originals.
I enjoy films. I will watch any films. The films today are inspired by films of yesteryear.
Mm.
The films of yesteryear was inspired by the films that were first made. All films inspired by other films and directors and actors.
Mm.
So I'm interested in every film there is. Because every film has a knock-on effect in another film.
Right.
You know.
But you don't like anything else?
Basically, yeah.
Anything there is in the film, can you fuck off?
Yes.
But I'm not like that.
No, you just stick to one formula.
No. Well, yeah. Okay. You're right. I like some deep stuff, adult stuff, you know?
Yeah.
Get in there.
Adult stuff.
You don't know shit, Jordan.
You don't know shit from a dirty pudding.
Well, I can cut that bit out. It was a door slam, so that's good. I was hoping we could cut that out. Right.
Anyway.
I was just lost my train of thought now. I think we got the instructions out of the way.
Yeah, it's quite good.
So...
That's our trailer for it, couldn't it?
A trailer?
The trailer,
not doing a trailer. A trailer's you do for something that people are already aware of, but just gets them more excited. Right? Like, you can't really do a trailer for something no one's heard of.
A trailer's an intro. A trailer introduces people, but then also hypes it as well.
Yeah, but like...
It's more of a marketing...
I feel like you can do it for something you don't know about, though. It depends.
If I see a trailer on TV and I think that looks good.
Yeah, but that's on TV, right?
Yeah.
Like, I mean, from our point of view, right? From our...
Yeah, I suppose.
Our little thing
on YouTube, yeah.
Yeah, if we put a trailer up for something on my channel, true. Right? No one's going to fucking see it, so what's even point? We might as well just bring out the whole show straight away.
I'm just saying,
if I had a bigger following. Like, at the moment, I've only got 13 subscribers.
Yeah.
None of them are going to fucking care.
I've got about three.
Three of the 13 of mine are probably subscribed to
you. One's you.
No, that's very unlikely, actually. Yeah, one of them's me. I'm not subscribed to myself, so...
Yeah, true.
You're probably subscribed to me, aren't you?
I think so, yeah. Must be.
If you're not, I'm going to fucking... I'm going to have some words. I've got a strongly worded letter for you, yeah. Jordan.
Thanks. Carrier pigeon.
I have to keep checking my laptop to make sure it's working, because it might end up blue screening.
What the fuck? I'm going to again.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go.
And we're doing a pretty stand-up job, aren't we, right now?
Oh, you? I'm sitting down, but yeah.
Yeah, well, so am I.
But we're doing a stand-up job then, aren't we?
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. I was joking anyway, I wasn't...
Oh, sorry.
So clearly we're not doing a stand-up job.
I was so serious. What's the last film you saw?
Last film I saw was Free Fire, right?
Good.
Which was in cinemas. I think it was. Yeah.
That's right.
That's a really good film, right? For you listeners out there, or you one listener.
I don't want to say anything about it.
I just want to say that it is really fucking good. Probably one of the best films I've seen this year. Yeah. It's got a really good cast, which is evident anyway.
It's got a good name as well.
It's got Cillian Murphy in it. It's got Michael Smiley in it. It's got Brie Larson in it. It's got Sharlto Copley. I think that's how you pronounce it.
I don't know. I'm
not going to try doing a South African. What?
Exclusively produced by Martin Scorsese.
Yes, well. I saw that on the credits, and I was like, what?
Must be a good film if he's put his name on it.
It is good. If you went to see a film like Get Out or something, and there was a trailer where there was a big gunfight and nothing else seemed to happen, then that's the film.
There must be more to it.
There must be more to it. You won't know until you see the film. Exactly. I'm just saying. Yeah. I mean, that's if you've seen it advertised, then that's the film I'm talking about. Go see it right now.
Alright.
I'm talking to you, Jordan.
Talk to me. What me? Yeah, no, I will see it. Sounds good.
I don't have a drink there. Do you want a drink?
I don't want a drink. What, one of yours? No.
Well, no, because
like the same bottle. Straw, same straw. No. Straw.
Okay. What about you? What have you? You saw The Shining.
Yeah, The Shining. Yeah. 1980 cubic. Good. It is good.
I think everyone knows The Shining, don't they?
I think so.
Are they going to remake that, do you think? I think they're planning to, aren't they?
Like, they will, but they shouldn't, because it's not really...
Okay.
I wouldn't call it a film
as
such. I think it's more of a sort of a reaction to other films.
Right.
Because it has it's wide angle, and the character's always in the middle of the thing. You think something's going to come out, yeah? And because you can see the whole location, but nothing does come out of you. And really, it's only at the end. Something actually happens at the end.
Hmm.
And it's clever. It's very clever. It's not your normal, bunch of teens have a pool party. So one of them gets murdered. Murders and bollocks like that. It's horror that the music is shit scary. It makes you jump the shit like. I was on ceiling most of the time. But nothing really happened. Nothing truly, jumpy, scary happens.
Hmm.
But you think something is because of the way it's filmed. It's more of a reaction to every horror film. And it's made in 1980, so there's a lot of crap horrors at the time of that sort of high school, really nasty stuff.
Right.
Which I enjoy thoroughly. But...
So what you're saying is...
What, sorry?
You should just skip to the end because nothing actually happens.
No, but it's not. I wouldn't recommend it. But I wouldn't recommend it for being a film that has an end, middle, start, middle, end.
Yeah, usually a film ends at the beginning.
Yeah, usually starts at the end. You know, you watch it and think, oh, it's fucking finished already. What's all that about? But it's more of a reaction to every other horror film. It's clever. If you like horror films, see that one because it'll change your mind. I have to see it again. It's one of the films you've got to see again.
It's one of those films I should see. The first time.
Yeah, exactly. You haven't seen it. But yeah, it's good. And Jack Nicholson's brilliant. Brilliant cast. The kid's brilliant. The woman's brilliant.
The woman.
Which I can't remember the name of. Which is a bit embarrassing.
Yeah, women are usually quite good, aren't they?
I don't mean sexually. Like,
no, I wasn't saying that.
I don't mean in sexist terms. I mean, not. I don't mean sexually. I mean, not in sex. No, I don't mean sexist.
I mean, acting, but you know. If you want to take it that way,
God.
Go for it.
Yeah, I did. It hurt. I mean, I forgot what the woman's name is, but I will mention her because she was good. Jack Nicholson's brilliant and the kid's good.
Yeah, he's good, isn't he?
Mm.
Well, you've half convinced me to watch it.
Sadly, I mean,
that's kind of the format of this, isn't it? That's the idea.
Yeah.
So you've got to convince me to watch an old film. I've got to convince you to watch a new film.
That's the concept, yeah.
Have I convinced you to watch Free Fire, by the way? I forgot to mention.
I wanted to see it anyway, to be fair. So. But yeah, you're... Fuck.
No point then, is there?
No. Really. Bit of a wasted...
I'm not sure if I want to see The Shining, to be honest. Because, no. Every time I see a bit of it, it's just like... Because I already know the story anyway. Mostly because of The Simpsons. But yeah. Also because... I don't really like the look of it, because it just seems too... what do you call it? Dated? That's what I mean, yeah.
Oh, it's not dated. It grabs you. It grabs you and you doesn't it go. But I think if you like films, you should watch it because it's very open and it's very cinematic. It's very clear, crystal clear. It's lovely settings and that. You know. But if you want to stick a film on and that has, like I say, a start, I'll get this right one day, start, middle and end, yeah. That isn't it for me, then I wouldn't recommend it, but then I would not recommend it.
Right.
So it'd be on your own head, but then you don't like horror films.
No,
you,
I do.
You
never said that.
Yeah, no, yeah, but it's not, you're not like a horror film fanatic, are you? You're not, you know, have no, you seen
but, I mean, I've
Texas
seen...
Chainsaw Massacre? Have you seen Let the Right One In? You know, Nightmares in a Damaged Brain. You right. know, SS Holocaust. No, so...
I haven't seen any of them.
No, so there you go, you know. You wouldn't... For me, it's sort of a reaction to that, but I've only seen it once, and it's one of the films you've got to see again.
Right.
So, who knows?
So you're saying it's more of an art film than a...
I wouldn't go that far, but I wouldn't say it's a Hollywood film, but then I wouldn't say it was an art film, because it's a Stanley Kubrick film. It's the same as sort of Tarantino films. It's a Kubrick film. So it's very Stanley Kubrick. It's not a bog standard film. But anyway, I can't really comment because I need to see it again.
Yeah, I'm just trying to think, like... But... Okay. No, I think you have convinced me. I'm going to have to... I mean, it's always one of those things you have to see.
Yeah.
And I've just and never gotten
everyone
to
everyone knows here's Johnny's scene, but there's a lot more to that.
But yeah. That's really but, annoying you know. Now, that's...
Yeah,
I think I've seen
that's what I thought.
Every time someone parodies it,
when you watch it though, when you watch that scene, it's amazing, and there's a lot more to that scene that people don't see.
Yeah,
and you should see it just for that. To be fair,
I've always the only thing I've seen, like I said, was the Simpsons version called The Shining. Have you seen it?
No,
you haven't. Seen it, no. Oh right, it was a Treehouse of Horror episode.
Oh, God,
you know they do them every year.
Yeah, of course.
And this was like
the final numbers, season.
Final season.
Yeah, I think so.
Of The Simpsons.
I think so, that's what you
said. Fuck off, that's not real.
Well, that's, I read something, I don't know.
Yeah, that was April Fool's probably.
Probably, yeah. It's pretty really bad.
Anyways, I was trying to tell you about The Shining.
Oh, yeah, sorry, mate. Yeah.
Okay. So, oi.
Sorry.
That's going to be in the
that's
thing.
That's a gerbil. That's a hamster, sorry.
No, it wasn't.
Yeah, it just came in. Asked us for popcorn and went back out again.
You got any sugar?
Yeah.
Why do people do that? Or why did people do that?
Because they got no sugar.
Oh,
what
right.
do you mean?
Yeah, well, okay. Yeah. Because people don't do it anymore because it's easier to get... Okay, sorry. Right, I'm cutting it out. So, anyways...
My students used to do it.
As we was talking... As we was trying... Our laptop... My laptop...
Yeah, his shit laptop.
Yeah.
You know, he's chucking coal right. in it.
Look, it's...
Ruined,
yeah.
Running, you know,
yeah. It works. All right?
Yeah.
It's been the family... it's been the family for generations.
Okay? All right.
No, not really. right, so you're saying... what was it?
Top 10 films?
No, clubs.
Clubbed, yeah, with Mal Rodeo and... Mark Salmon in it. It's, good film.
Right.
Good film. This bloke, he loses his kids, his family. Like, he gets a divorce, loses, you know, the kids, he's only allowed to see the kids once in a while. And he's not all, he suffers from depression. Mark Rodeo's character. He's a brilliant actor, love him. Mal Rodeo. And then he takes the girls to the dance club, and there's a boxing place there, and he gets introduced to boxing, and he meets this bloke played by Mark Salmon, I think it's Mark Salmon, come from Luton. Yeah, he's a good actor, but he learns and he makes him stronger, and you know, he's an 18 and it's about gangsters, and there's people smash everyone up. It's nothing about that really. It's about the inner struggle of life, and the way, you know, and it's just the way that you need to find something to believe in, and you need to keep following that thing. It's not really about, you know, shoot 'em up gangsters and all that bollocks. It's really good, and about friendship as well, and loyalty, and There's a great twist at the end. Brilliant film. Got to see it. That's, you know, my first joint, really. You know, one film we've got to see because, it's brilliant. You know, it really is good.
Right.
I don't know if I've done that justice.
Well, when did it come out?
2008.
2008, okay. 2008. So, it's new enough for me to enjoy.
Yeah. It's just brilliant.
It's a film.
It's a film.
Okay.
And it's like I say, it's got a mask on, basically, of a gangster film, people like beating people up, violence. It's nothing to do about that. It's about life and, how.
Yeah, but does it make it obvious that it's about that, or are you just looking into it too much like you usually do?
Oh, thanks. It's not, because it doesn't, the characters are called, they're not called Bullet Tooth Tony or fucking, any of that.
Mm.
They're not going around shooting AK-47s, jumping in Jaguars and spinning around coal with boxes. It's nothing to do about it. Just a bunch of guys who've been friends for a while. This new kid comes in. He's obviously had a bit of a hard life, lost his family, and he finds this little, among all the coal in the basket, he finds this one little gem, and he keeps finding it, and then obviously among that thing he finds, he's got a family, he's got this new family, and they gel together and they're friends, and this loyalty comes along and they stick up for each other.
Hmm.
And it's amazing. And then so obviously something happens and the end is a really clever end. It's
you're right.
It's amazing. It's not me looking too much into it.
I'm just joking. And,
but it's seriously like one of the films that it's easy just to watch and go, yeah, bollocks, but it speaks a lot, about the struggle of life. It's quite good.
Alright.
Anyways. So I went a bit deep then, I did like
that. That's good, yeah. Well, you convinced me. You convinced me to watch it.
Oh, thanks. That's the idea. It's the idea of this podcast.
Yeah, it is the idea.
It's just scribe and shit.
Can you stop fucking fidgeting?
Sorry.
If you fidget about it.
It's on wheels. My chair's on wheels.
They're going to hear more of you just...
They're like an old age pensioner. No wheels in their chair, don't they?
Yeah. A wheelchair. Yeah, but that's a desk chair. It's not a wheelchair, is it?
Yeah, but I'm not at a desk. I'm at like a microphone, so...
This is a makeshift desk.
Yeah, but don't worry, don't tell them that. It's like a gold-plated desk.
Yeah, it's got 70 legs.
Yeah, and...
It's got wheels on the legs.
Like cocaine on the side and a bit of Uncle Charlie. Cocaine,
yeah, it's all the way around the edge.
Yeah, but sniff.
It's like secret compartments in it where you can hide your cigars and...
Yeah, and your money. Stacks of £1.
Your stacks of...
£1.
New £1 coins. Yeah.
Ain't got any of them yet.
No. I went to John Lewis. It's because of where I work, by the way, if you want to pop by. Where I work, we was advertising that, look at the new £1, they're coming soon. Yeah. And I thought that meant we'd get some. But then again, I was in dishwasher all day, so it's not like it's I come into contact with money.
It's either on the floor and the dishwasher. I don't know,
What?
And you just get more away, because I
No. I give it more than that.
Yeah.
Well, let's not get too deep into the personal lives.
Oh, yeah, sorry, not too deep.
We don't want people,
Yeah, like stalkers and paparazzi and shit.
Because, everyone loves us, everyone wants to stalk us.
Can't get them off.
Can't get them off.
Anyway, yeah, top 10 films.
Yeah, so I have a list of top 10 films.
Right.
Do
with a laugh, go on.
Yeah, I'm still working on it, I mean, it's one of those things that there's never a concrete one. But this is
He's numbered them and he's put 10 in there.
Yes.
It's like this is
kind of definitive for the time right now.
Who goes out with like the dead cert amount in their wallet to go to the shops with. Like, I'm not gonna spend no more, no less. It's the top 10 films. Okay, sorry. Still in the limelight.
Yeah, but you got like fucking 20-100 favourites, right?
Yeah, you've got every film.
Of course you can like more than one film or more than 10, but I like to have a set little list. And it's really nice to look at the list. It's just like going, it just looks really good,
Yeah, but if you look at the list, I think that's just a load of shite.
At this list, but I quite like.
Yeah,
this.
I do. Your list.
You haven't seen half of these bloody films, anyways.
I've seen most of them.
Okay, yeah, but you haven't seen some of the new ones.
No, go on. Explain your list.
I'm not yet because I haven't finished explaining. Oh, right?
Sorry.
So it's not going to be like this forever, right? No. This isn't definitive, but like at the moment, and we could, you know, if I've changed it, I'll, you know, I'll update the list. In fact, I might even put a link to the list on the description or something.
Yeah, if you want a quick so laugh,
people,
to yourself,
can, yeah,
to
people can bloody mock me for my shitty list.
No, it's not bad. It's just
no, you said it now.
It's like the same genre. I don't know. You're directing me.
It's not the same genre.
Cut that bit out.
There's...
Cut out.
No, not cutting anything out.
Jordan,
you always sound like a twat no matter what.
Oh, thanks.
Don't have to...
We're going to split up, isn't it? It's the first one. We're going to split this podcast up.
I'm just looking, actually. Most of it is the same. There's a couple on there that are different. But most of it is kind of the same genre.
I can't explain your list,
please. Right, anyways. So, at number 10 is Arrival. From 2016. It. You haven't seen it yet?
I haven't seen it yet.
Okay,
I see
this
it,
is one I should try and convince you to watch then. So,
I will see it.
Yeah, but I'm trying to convince you to see it now, rather than 20 years.
We're doing a podcast, can't watch it now.
No, but I mean, rather than next year.
Oh,
because you're already like a year behind on it anyway.
Yeah, I know. Sorry.
So basically, it's about Nicole Kidman, right?
Jesus.
No, wait. Right, Lois
That's
Lane.
A code word. Not everyone will understand that.
No, yeah, I just sometimes get
Nocturnal
her...
Nocturnal Animals.
I get her confused when I see her face, okay? Is that what the film's called? Nocturnal Animals?
That's the one with
yeah.
Jake Gunnar.
Yeah, so like there's a poster of Nocturnal Animals. It's Nicole Kidman. No, Amy Adams is in that film.
And Jake
I keep thinking it's Nicole Kidman.
It's the second one to Arrival. You know, she did a double bill, obviously.
Yeah, and I keep thinking it's Nicole Kidman every time I see that poster.
It's annoying.
Is the one with just her face and then like he's Jake Gyllenhaal's like...
Yeah, sort of shadow poster, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I keep thinking it's Nicole Kidman. Anyways, this Arrival, I don't know. I don't really want to tell you too much because...
I know.
You already
know,
like...
I want to see
the general idea is that there's, like, these aliens have come down...
Big cubes.
And they've got a linguist and a scientist to come and... Cubes? No, they're like...
Not cubes, yeah.
They're like discs, aren't they?
Yeah.
Like the sideways discs.
Yeah.
They're like minstrels, but you've just eaten,
you bloke?
You've eaten half the minstrel. What?
Is he a bloke?
Jeremy Renner, isn't it?
Yeah.
So he's the scientist. And so they've been asked by the military to come along and talk to the aliens.
Right.
In the ship, right? Did you know
that? I knew that now, yeah.
Did I just spoil it?
No, I knew that. I know the base of it, yeah.
They've come to try and suss out what's going on.
Yeah.
Right? And it's got a really good... Well, it's certainly not what you expect to see when you watch it, really. That's all I'm going to say. But yeah, watch that, because it's good. It's on DVD, Blu-ray.
Yeah, it is.
Not that you can watch it on Blu-ray. Oh, no, you can.
Can't watch on Blu-ray.
Fuck off, John.
Does it on video? I want to watch on video.
You can't watch on video. Shut up. Right. Next one is Deadpool.
Yeah.
But that's. I feel like I'm probably going to end up
admitting. I'm in my top 50 for that.
Oh, yeah. But, I feel like I'd take that off the list soon.
The first sort of 10 minutes of that film, it just absolutely blew my mind when I saw it, to be fair.
I haven't actually seen it since I saw it in cinema. I saw it twice.
I saw it twice at cinema.
I haven't seen it since.
Three times before.
It's really weird, though, because, it's been a year since it came out, and I haven't seen it since.
Have you got it?
I haven't got it, no.
It's about 10, I think.
I bought it for someone once. But
yeah, for me, that's one of them films that... I wouldn't say it's a classic. I don't know if I would recommend it. But no, it would be on my list of... If there's only one film I could watch before I die, that would be on that list.
Right.
Of, you know...
If you hadn't seen it, or just to see it again?
Yeah, it's one of the films you just love.
Right.
It's, you know, it's just lovely.
Yeah, if you know you're going to die, you'd watch it again.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
It's not, you know, not deep. It's not stupidly overrated. It's not CGI.
No, but it's got some really great moments throughout.
It's just brilliant. It is what it is.
Mm. And Ryan Reynolds is perfect for it. I think we know that.
Is Deadpool, yeah.
Without doubt. Definitely not Hal Jordan.
Publicize that.
He's not Green Lantern, is he?
Years. Wait to see the film.
Yeah. Have you seen The Green Lantern?
No.
That's really bad.
Didn't want to see it. Shit.
I saw it once. It was really bad. So don't see that. Whatever you do.
What, Green Lantern?
Yeah.
No, I won't.
He was alright in it, though. But it's just like...
Yeah, shit. I don't want to see it.
Mark Strong's in it. He's Sinestro. He's really good.
Yeah, Strong.
He's good in anything, really, isn't he?
Mark Strong. He's a bollocks, but you don't get the scripts you should get, the films you should get.
I feel like he doesn't really want to be in the spotlight, though, does he? Has he ever been?
No, but I mean the films, you know, the British films like Births, Deaths and Marriages, he's in that with Ray, that's a TV series, with Ray Winston and the other bloke that I never remember the name, but he's also very good. with Mark Strong. And that's brilliant.
Right.
And that's what Mark should be, a football-loving person who, you know, has got young kids, he's got a house, got a car. But he's always the uncle of someone or the brother of someone.
Mm.
And he's, you know, he's always bald. I don't No, you know what I mean?
He might have a condition, you know. Doesn't Patrick Stewart have one of those things? Right, he's just...
What do you mean,
condition? He can't grow hair.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, Patrick Stewart can't grow
hair. That's called being bald.
Yeah, but like,
that is the conditioner.
Yeah, but you can go bald. But like, I mean, yeah. As in you can just shave your head bald,
yeah.
Can't you?
Yeah.
But you can also just like have a condition where you can't grow hair at all, right?
Yeah,
I think Mark Strong might have that.
Bald, yeah.
I might be getting that myself.
Anyway, yeah.
I'm joking, jeez.
I hope so.
Well, sorry, derailed.
Yeah, derailed again.
Oh, actually, no, I was going to say about Mark Strong.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Have you seen Grimsby?
No, I'm not yet.
You have to see that film as well. That's good. Because that's probably one of the first films I've seen him in where he's the main character. Well, one of the main characters.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's more so about Sacha Baron Cohen, but.
Yeah, he's his brother.
Yeah, that's really good. You have to see it. I mean, it's not good, it's just mental.
Yeah, like Deadpool is.
Yeah. Yeah, I suppose.
It's one of them films.
I don't know. It's in a different league, really.
Yeah, but you know what I mean? It's that sort of same.
You haven't seen Green TV, so you can't say.
It's a comedy. It's like.
It's a comedy, yes.
It's,
I can't remember it very well now.
It's good.
There's one particular scene that is quite traumatising. I won't go into it, but.
What is it? Does it involve a lion?
Doesn't involve a lion.
Does it involve some animals?
It involves an animal, anything. But let's not go into it. You probably heard about it before, but.
Yeah.
But, you know, I don't want to spoil
next
it.
Film.
Right, so number 8, which I'm definitely not taking off the list, by the way,
right.
Is Space Jam.
Fair enough. No comment. Yeah, no, it's all right.
I don't know. It's more just a nostalgic one.
Bill Murray.
But they just really like it. Oh, yeah, but Bill Murray's in it.
Yeah, so you got to love that scene. It's a pretty good scene.
Oh, you saw it for the first time recently, didn't you?
Yeah, I think so.
A few months ago, I think, actually.
Yeah.
We watched it.
Yeah, it's all
right. It's just all right. Give you a little... That's my mum. Mum's home.
Mum's home.
So I should probably say something to her so she doesn't interrupt.
Oh, yeah, I'll keep on talking.
Give you a review of Space Jam. Don't touch it. Don't touch it.
Yeah, Space Jam's alright, but, you know. It was alright.
What?
Sorry, I didn't actually talk anything there. Just cut that bit out.
I'm going to give you a review of Space Jam.
No, I've never seen it, man.
Maybe you got to give you a review. That's what this is for.
Yeah, but it's a good film. That's the sort of film I couldn't review, because it's just a film. It's like...
Well, you actually said it's a good film?
Yeah, it's a funny film. I could sit there and watch it again. Your kids would like it. Your dad would like it.
Oh, yeah, everyone would
like it. Your granddad would like it. Your pet cat would like it. Yeah. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's one of them films.
I feel like Space Jam's one of those films.
If it's not, worth it's air not... time, I don't think it is.
Okay.
If you know what I mean. Like,
yeah.
It's not like, oh yeah, this bit really, it's really deep, this bit.
Oh, right,
yeah,
right.
Spoke to me.
Oh, no, no, it's not amazing. No. It's not the best film you've ever seen.
But it's a film, and it's one of the
It's definitely watching. Just a film.
So, Black Beauty, or, I don't know.
Black Beauty?
Yeah, or Lambda. I don't know. Have you seen it? You and he's seen it? I think,
I don't know if I'd recommend that Suicide you have Squad. To see it. Let's not talk about Suicide Squad. We're talking about Space Jam. It's completely unrelated. Look. It's just I don't remember seeing Michael Jordan in that, do you?
No, I don't.
Look, I don't know, like, would you recommend someone sees it? Because like, no matter what, if it comes on and you watch, or you end up watching it, you're not gonna not like it, are you? You're gonna like it.
But then,
but do you go out of your way to see it?
But no.
No,
I don't think it would. I think everyone's seen it. I think it's one of the films that you'll just see it anyway, naturally see it.
Yeah, you most likely.
Yeah.
Anyone that's watched this has probably seen it at some point, surely.
Yeah.
And if they haven't, what are you doing?
Yeah, put your finger out your arse and fucking watch it.
Go watch bloody Space Jam.
Everyone's probably got it as well, funny enough. Everyone had it on video, to be fair. It's like E.T. and 9, whatever, 98.
I don't think I've had it on.
Everyone had E.T. on bootleg, didn't they?
E.T.?
Yeah. It was the first bootleg ever.
I don't really like E.T.
It's funny, isn't it? It's like canine, almost.
Canine?
Yeah. He's like,
Well, Canine from Doctor Who?
Yeah.
Is he?
Well, he's on wheels. That's what I'm trying to say. E.T.'s on wheels.
No, he's not. He's not on wheels.
You can see it looks crap. It's a good film. It looks crap.
I'm going to find this.
I did a good job at it. But
I'm going to find E.T. on wheels. You ready?
Yeah, when he comes out of the woods.
I don't remember. I haven't really seen it in a long time.
Anyway,
it comes up with a car.
I don't care. What's the next film? It's supposed to be a film podcast, not an
argument. We're talking about E.T. That's a film. Fucking hell. No, I was going to say about Space Jam.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Go on.
It's just one of... Yeah, it's just like more of a nostalgic thing. But I do really enjoy it. There's one particular bit I really love, right? Where the aliens first arrive on Earth and they go through the hole and they're going down in underground and they're driving through a tunnel underground.
Yeah.
And the Warner Brothers logo is there.
Oh, yeah.
And they go...
Yeah.
Like, the music's playing and it gets louder as it gets closer.
Yeah.
And they just... Like, I always loved that as a kid. Like, and then as they crash through it, they crash into the sky, like through the sky.
Yeah.
And they end up in the cartoon world. That's really cool. I just love that. I think that's brilliant. And it's a rabbit hole as well, isn't it? Which is... Bugs Bunny would have made it, wouldn't he?
Yeah.
Bugs Bunny's the god of their
world. All right. Leave religion out of this podcast.
He's a god, though. I worship Bugs Bunny every day.
You dropped the religion bar.
Every day, before I sit down for dinner, I put my hands together,
yeah.
I close my eyes, and I say, what's up, Doc? And then I eat my dinner.
Yeah.
Much of a carrot,
yeah. Yeah.
And then I have the rest of my dinner.
Oh, God.
So, number 7 is Logan.
It's a
new one that's come out recently.
I haven't seen
it. Apparently, it's still in cinemas. Dating it again.
Exactly, yeah.
But yeah, you should see that film, Jordan.
But yeah, I will see it. Don't.
I'm not going to know. I know. I don't want to talk too much about films that you haven't seen.
Just leave it there. Next one.
I just want to say it's a really good film. It's number 7 on my list, so it's going to be
everyone
good.
Everyone says it makes them cry. So
it's one of the best superhero films ever made.
Yeah.
Although I've got some more on this list.
Yeah.
That superhero films which are better, but that's just my opinion.
All right. Next one.
Number 6 is The World's End.
Yeah, it's the first film I saw.
The first film that you saw?
Nick Frost, Simon Pegg and Edgar Wright saga.
Yeah, that was the first one you saw?
Yeah. Well, at least wanted to see sort of Shaun of the Dead.
Hmm.
Remember that as a kid, everyone's like, oh, Shaun of the Dead.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, Run, Fat Boy, Run, I always saw that trailer for that and I always wanted to see it.
Hmm.
But, you know, World's End was, great film.
I have a little bit of a story about that, right? So I saw Shaun of the Dead first, because that's the first one that came out. But I saw that, like, years after it came out, I think. It was on TV one night.
Yeah.
And I was just really bored, I had nothing to do. And I think everyone got to bed, and I was just like, oh, let's just watch a film. Late night, you know, sit up late and watch a film. And Shaun of the Dead came on, I thought, oh, this would be a good film, like, you know, night time. Oh, because I thought it was a horror film.
Yeah, I heard.
Yeah, because it was because Dawn of the Dead and Shaun of the Dead, I got them mixed up. So I thought, oh, this is a horror film, so I'll watch
it. George Ramone, Die of the Dead, brilliant.
Yeah.
And Night of the Living Dead also is one of my favourites, Conan.
Yeah, stop interrupting me.
Just, I thought I'd slip that one in. No wonder.
Stop interrupting me. So, sat down to watch a horror film, and it turned out into comedy, and I was blown away by it. I thought it was amazing.
Yeah.
That's the story. And then, when World's End came out, I hadn't seen Hot Fuzz.
Yeah.
And there was like a triple bill thing they're doing at the cinema, so I managed to see all three of them at the same time. So, I was watching them in order, basically, but you saw the last one first.
Yeah. And obviously,
possibly
Fantastic
not the
Fear
last
of
one.
Everything,
hmm?
The Peggy film, Fantastic Fear of Everything, Simon Pegg film.
Hmm.
That film for me, that's probably the first Peggy film I saw. Simon Pegg. Always called Peggy. Simon Pegg film.
Peggy from.
And I love that film as well. And Hector's Search Happiness is probably one of my favourite films. I love that film. For just a sheer vibe, just amazing, I think. Just a really good. Just a, this psychiatrist went on to find happiness. He's feeling a bit down. You know, he had the perfect world, you know, wife, house, you know, friends. So he went on to look for happiness because he felt really down. And he knew he already had it. It was a really good film. So see that one as well. Talking about Simon Pegg, but yeah, go on. We've done another underpart now, sorry.
Simon Pegg. Yeah, he's a good guy.
I love Peggy. He's one of my biggest favourite.
I like Nick Frost as well.
Without Simon Pegg, we wouldn't have Nick Frost. Without Nick Frost, we wouldn't have Simon Pegg.
Yeah, exactly.
Without them two, you wouldn't have Edgar Wright.
Yeah, Edgar Wright is great.
Yeah, I'd never even know them to. We've gone for this.
They're just a bloody love triangle, aren't they?
Yeah, it's like bread, jam, and bread, you know? You can't have, like, just jam. You can't just have, like, one slice of bread and jam.
I have bread.
You've got to have, like, jam.
I have bread quite a lot on its own.
So do I. For this bit. You know?
That's almost like bread is the Simon Pegg, really, isn't he?
Yeah.
Because, like, he's the one that's.
He's the one that says
he's
a
the centre of the centre of it kind of thing, don't you think?
I don't know. I think he's the funny one. I think he's in the middle.
I don't
he's
give
the
him all
central
the credit,
one.
That's what I'm
but I think Nick Frost, he is who he is because of Simon Pegg. And if you split them two up, I don't think he's as good.
No.
He bounces off Peggy really well, and that's what works in the films.
Yeah.
And I think Edgar Wright, he can direct any film because he's so film, you know, he loves every film.
Mm.
And that's why he's so good, and that's what he adds to it. You know, so I think, I think Peggy's more central, like I say, and people put him more central. But I don't think he is.
Sorry, Nick Frost,
yeah.
You've listened.
But I love Nick Frost. I love him. And he is, you know, but I don't think if Simon, you know, because obviously he met the wrong person, he met Nick Frost instead. So it was a bit more, you know, it's one of the things that, you know, if Nick wasn't born, alive, whatever, Peggy wouldn't be Peggy. But then if Peggy was not alive, born, whatever, you know, Nick wouldn't be him either.
Mm.
So, you know.
Yeah.
You know.
Mm. And the reason why World's End is on the list instead of the other two, although I think most people would probably agree that the other two are better. Hot Fuzz is probably the better one,
yeah,
most people say, but I don't know, it's just World's End just always gets me. I think it's just because it's more sci-fi. I like more sci-fi stuff.
Yeah,
I think the ending works really well as well. I think Shaun of the Dead has a really good ending. Hot Fuzz's ending is sort of anticlimactic for me, yeah, personally, but the ending for World's End is just like, it's just sort of like a big twist kind of thing. It's like you're not expecting that kind of ending.
Yeah.
So I think it works better.
Yeah.
That's why I think that's because it's. I feel like World's End is a more solid film, I guess. Like it works all the way through.
Yeah.
They're all good all throughout. I'm just saying, you know, if you're trying to compare the three of them, well, they can't really, can you? But
no.
At the end, Hot Fuzz is a bit anticlimactic. Shaun of the Dead is the start. I feel like this, it doesn't quite capture everything that they do with the other two.
Yeah.
Do you get me?
Yeah.
So I feel like World's End is like the culmination of everything. And just, they finally sort of figured out everything, proper formula. They got it all together.
Yeah.
I feel like that's the definitive
film. It's more money,
film commercial for them.
A bit more commercial than the other two.
Yeah, it's a bit more, but that's because they've got more.
Everyone loved them, yeah.
Attention at that point.
That's
so,
what, you know, that's what a name of an artist has to do.
I think if they do a fourth one, that would be too, like.
We're not about a sort Hollywood of retirement one, are they? Like a,
yeah, apparently.
Sort of holiday one.
But then that's not a trilogy anymore, is it? You've got to have a trilogy. You can't have a quadrilogy.
No. Well, yeah, but it'd be standalone films. That's when they were young, sort of thing. That's the ideas they had when they were sort of kids.
What's the new trilogy? Edgar
Wright had the idea of... Yeah, Edgar Wright had the idea of World's End when he was in his student days, didn't he? When he was like 19 or something, he had the idea of going back to your old town and it's all changed.
Yeah.
There's a new Costa or something. Yeah, the idea when he was a kid.
Yeah.
Not a kid, but, you know, when he was a student.
When he was a young man.
And then he come out, and then when he was doing all these films, he was with Peggy and Frosty, they Tony the Tiger.
Peggy and Frosty.
Yeah. And that's what, you know, they obviously added a sci-fi bit to it, but yeah. Not just a sci-fi bit, though, you know.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, I'd say the best film in the Cornetto trilogy is Paul.
Yeah. But it's not even right. You wouldn't.
I'm joking. Yeah. God, fucking.
Oh, sorry. Sorry. I was having a serious accident there.
Sorry. I do like Paul though, don't you?
I
kind of like it. Like.
But it just, like, so you just like, because it's American.
Yeah, it's just Americanized version of them, of that kind of formula.
But Paul's brilliant. Yeah.
Just I mean Seth Rogen.
Yeah.
That's probably his best film, I think.
Yeah, everything else.
Everything else he does is shite.
Yeah.
No, he's bloody Paul.
Yeah, but I mean, he's not in it.
Oh, he's
don't go back to this argument.
Oh, okay, right, here we go.
His voice is in it.
Yeah, that means he's in it.
Yeah, but his soul, body and soul.
Yeah, physically,
not in
he's not in it, but he's still in it because he performed in it.
His voice performed in it.
Yeah, so he's in it.
Yeah, all
right. Okay.
Voice acting, yeah.
Bloody hell, we always have this argument.
I know.
We come to the same conclusion though every time.
He's not, you know, it's not like I went to a film, went to cinema, and saw a film of Seth Rogers in it.
Seth Rogen, yeah.
Seth Rogen, sorry.
Mr. Rogers.
I was thinking of Buck Rogers then. But, and I saw him in it, and it's brilliant. You wouldn't watch it just for him, because he's not in it. He's not acting in it. His voice is in
it. He's acting in it.
And you go, oh, yeah, Sting in it. His voice is really good.
It's
really
voice acting.
Voice acting, yeah.
But when, I'd still go to a film just to hear someone's voice.
Oh, I would too. I wouldn't say I wouldn't.
Yeah.
But you don't watch a whole film, and there's an animated character in it, and you go, oh, that's a really good voice. You say it's a really good voice.
Because they're
in, that's not them. They're not acting.
They are.
They're not. They're voice acting. They're talking.
That's still voice acting.
Yeah,
they're
still acting.
Yes, they're still
but
in
it's
it.
But That's not acting in the sense of he's an actor, he is acting. He's a voice actor, and he acts with his voice. Different.
But hold on, Jordan. Let me just say, voice acting is very underrated from what you're saying. Like, you're very underrating voice acting.
No, I'm not.
It's extremely hard to do.
Yeah, I know, 100%.
Because I kind of know, but, like, if you're just talking, it's not a proper good performance.
Yeah, all right. I didn't mean talking. I mean, that is still acting.
Yeah.
But it's not acting with the whole body. It's not putting on the costume, acting with the whole body. Obviously, you do behind the scenes, but it's not in the film.
But you can't say that that's not just as good as a performance or...
No, I'm not saying it's not... Okay, good. It's not any difference. It's not like, acting is shit. I'm not saying that.
Because they don't have a costume, because they're not in it.
No, I'm not...
Physically, you're saying that they're not in it.
For me, yeah. Because when I go to a film, you know, I don't... Like, I don't know what you don't get. Like, I mean,
I don't get.
That. I mean, it's two different, not two different completely spectrums, but two different things, where it's a lot harder, like you say, but you know, it's not in it as. I can't see him, you know.
Doesn't mean he's not in it though.
If his voice is in, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, so
he's not in it because you can't see him.
No, his voice is part of him. No, you can't just declare that you win. Right? Hold on. Okay, first of all, when we say that someone's in it, right, they're not even in anything, are they? Because the physical being, their spirit, isn't even... Wait, stop. Just because you're fucking losing, right?
Yeah.
You're trying to distract him.
Yeah, but I know what I mean, but I can't say it.
Yeah, I know what you mean, but you're wrong, right?
All right. Okay. You're all right, as usual.
Yeah, as usual, I am right. I stand by the fact that just because only their voices, they're still in it. We're in this podcast, aren't we? We're still in this podcast, aren't we?
Yeah, but our voices are in it.
Yeah,
we're still acting, in it. We're not doing voices.
We're still in it, though, aren't we?
Yeah, but this is like radio. TV took over radio.
They're still on the radio then, aren't they? They're just not... You can't say they're not in it.
The voices in it.
Yeah, the voice is in it. Okay.
It plays the voice of Paul. Not he is okay. Paul. Well, no, not he is Paul. He is Paul because he's the voice of it.
Yes.
But it's not like, you know...
He's still in Paul, though, isn't he?
What is it?
Man, maybe he likes it that way. No, but what I'm trying to say is...
Anyway, moving on.
Okay. Yeah, this is getting shit, right? But I want to end this. This is very petty. You're the one being petty, right?
I'm not being petty.
When we say that someone's in a film,
yeah,
we don't mean literal, physically. Especially if it's just their voice, they're still in it. They're still a part of it, aren't they?
The voices, yeah.
Yes.
Because they're contributing to the voice.
So they're still in the film.
Hmm.
Okay, can we leave it there? because I've still got more of the list to do.
Director or producer or whatever. You can't go the list.
Only like halfway through the list.
You know, that's the director's thing. You know, the director makes his film because it's part of his life, or it's a part of his life that he wanted to be, or it's about him or something he knows.
Yeah.
But it doesn't mean he's in it.
No, he's not in it.
Yeah, but he is, though, because it's his thing, isn't
it? He's not in it, though. He's not, like, he's not in the story. He's not in the...
Yeah, because it's his voice. Because that's the thing he wants to speak about. That's the thing he wants to show his fans.
No, but he made it. He wasn't in it.
That's the same as actors, isn't it?
Unless he had a cameo in it.
It's kind of the same thing.
Unless he had a cameo
as voice acting.
Unless he had a cameo.
You know, I'm not saying voice acting is no better. I'm not saying acting is no better or whatever. Because voice acting is very hard. You can see it behind the scenes. They're full on.
Mm. You can hear it sometimes, isn't
anyway,
their voice?
Next film.
Right.
Yeah, oh yeah, it makes it.
Cut out all that.
No, not cutting out. We're keeping that in, but that's a separate thing. We're keeping that.
We're in, we're out. Shaking it all about.
Yeah. Right? Do the hokey hokey.
No.
Turn around.
We're not doing the hokey fucking cokey.
Excuse me.
Number five.
Number five.
In the list is...
Who's got my list to do?
Excuse me. No, we're not doing your list. Fuck off.
Yeah,
you don't have a list. Yeah,
that's
30-odd
films on my list.
We can do it next episode, right?
Why are we doing this episode? Let's get on.
Number five is Little Miss Sunshine.
Yeah, fair enough.
Okay. It's got Abigail Breslin. I think it's one of her first films. I really like Abigail Breslin. I always have, even though she was a little kid, it's a little bit weird. In this film, anyway.
Yeah.
I always liked her just as an actress, anyway. She's just really great. And I've got it on DVD if you want to borrow it.
Yeah, I did borrow it as well.
You did before, yeah.
Yeah.
But,
yeah, it was alright. I wouldn't, jump that chance.
Yeah, I suppose so. It was just, I think it's just, a lot of these films, well, not a lot of them, but some of them, it's just like, I saw them on TV, and I just thought, fuck it, I'll watch it. And I ended up just loving it, because it's one of those, like, it's like a hidden gem to me. Like, it's just like, it was just on. Like, I just stumbled upon it. And it just sort of shocks me if I find something really good. It's just really, I don't know. But it's also just because I really connect with all the characters, really.
Yeah, it's quite a whole one.
Yeah, but it's also, it's quite dark, really, at the same time, isn't it?
Yeah. That's what I say again. Good comment.
No comment. okay, well, let me see if I can explain it to the audience, because I don't think a lot of people have seen this film. Don't fucking do that. He just put his head in his hand. I mean, I know no one can see it, but you just... Right, fine, I won't go into it then. Jesus. I thought that's what this whole thing's supposed to be.
I'm gone.
We talked about a lot of films today, but...
Yeah.
Little Miss Sunshine. It's just, I don't know. Oh, it's hard to explain. Steve Carell's in it, you know. Everyone likes Steve Carell, don't
they? It's just about a family, but...
Well, I thought I was doing this. No, I'm right, you need to go for it.
Well, no, you'll take ages. No,
you obviously got it better than me.
Well, I don't really, but...
Well, no, because I
can't. This is just from someone who's watched it once.
Yeah, go on then.
It's just a family maybe not get on, and at the end of the film they get on, and they...
You know what I mean?
It basically is, isn't it, really? You know, we're all different, we all have illnesses, we all have weaknesses, we're all human. Let's just get on.
Yeah, that's basically what the film is, yeah.
You know, sweet little film.
And it's more from the girl's perspective, I suppose, isn't it?
I suppose. I don't know. That's how I miss it again, really.
What was her name? Anyways, sure. Abigail Breslin's character.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just, I think the whole thing's just really good. It's just really well acted, I think.
Yeah.
Even Steve Carell, like, he does a proper, like, serious role, really, doesn't he?
Oh, yeah.
In this one.
Yeah.
Which he's good at anyway, I'm just saying.
Yeah,
absolutely. It's on number 5 on my list, so it's got to be good, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, I understand.
I mean, not saying all these films are good because they're on my list, but you know what I mean.
All right.
Okay, so number 4.
Number 4.
This one you won't like at all. You can probably see it already.
No, I can't see
it. It's Man of Steel.
Fair enough.
That's true. What the fuck? You can hear that in your voice. It's like, God, what's he doing?
Yes.
It's the first in the DC Extended Universe.
Is it?
You can see my Blu-ray over there, actually. Yeah. It's on the top.
You can't, because obviously... It's just...
No, you can't, but he can.
I could face the microphone, you might be able to hear it, but...
You'd be able to
hear it. If I rustle it about...
Yeah, you'd be able to make out... Like, you use echolocation, you might be able to hear it.
Yeah.
Anyways.
Anyway.
Just offended all the blind people.
I didn't say anything about blind people.
I didn't say that. You started it. You said you might be able to hear it. No, you start.
Yeah, as I'm facing the microphone to it.
Anyways, Man of Steel.
Yeah.
It's quite a bit controversial. Because, well, all the DC films at the moment are pretty shite.
I just want to put in a statement.
Okay.
DC's shit, and Marvel's 100% better. Marvel could not make a bad film at the moment because DC's so shit.
Right, you stabbed me in the heart, because I like DC films.
I know you do.
I mean, exactly. I know I said they're shit, right, because they aren't good. I know that I admit they're not good, but I embrace them because I just love DC and I've always wanted to see them, like, all together properly, you know?
Yeah.
Justice League's coming out this year. Very excited for that. Yeah, I know, you've dated it too much now, but who cares? So...
But the thing is, I've just watched Suicide Squad.
What, recently?
No, I'm just saying, I've watched that film just so they can make another film just about that film.
But I say Suicide Squad's more standalone. But Batman vs Superman is definitely just to set up Justice League.
Yeah, 100%, that's what I mean, sorry.
But Suicide Squad's not as much, I think.
No, sorry.
Yeah.
Sorry. Batman vs Superman.
Suicide Squad.
It's just, I sat through that 2.5 whatever film.
Yeah.
Just so they can make...
Justice League.
Mm-hmm. That's crap, it's like watching over. It's like, I could see in the trailer, or read an interview that he's going to be in it, she's going to be in it, he's going to be in it.
Mm.
And not seeing Batman vs Superman. Mm. And they could have saved all that money making a better film of Justice League. But instead they didn't. They made a shit film. Wasted all that money, directors, actors, producers, you know, all that. Just so they can make an advert, a long advert, for another film. That's wrong.
Yeah. But no, I agree.
Do you like the film?
I do like it, because I think there's actually some parts I really enjoy in it. And I've got like a 3-hour version of it.
Yeah.
And the ultimate edition. But just trying to defend it is really hard. I don't really want to, because it doesn't deserve defending. really. But personally, I just really enjoy it anyway, for what it is. For all its crappiness, yeah. I don't want to talk about it too much, because I think it's been done to death now.
Anyway, Man of Steel.
Yeah, but Man of Steel, though, out of all the DC films that are out at the moment, there's like three at the moment. Wonder Woman's coming out soon.
Yeah.
Not sure about that one either. But Man of Steel, there's the first one, and I think it's the best out of all of them. It's not necessarily a really great film. I don't know, but like, I have a bit of a personal attachment to it anyway. It resonated with me in a more personal way, in an emotional way, because it's like, it's about, at its core, it's about a guy who can't fit in, and a guy who feels like an alien, because he literally is, but also he becomes a superhero, so it's like, it's just got like...
You directed it again, so?
Zack Snyder.
Yeah.
For me, I think that's one of his better films, but that's like, because I don't think he's come out with a good film ever.
Yeah.
300, probably the closest one, but...
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, not quite.
It's probably my favourite superhero film. But I know it's not probably the best one ever made.
Yeah.
No, definitely not, actually. But it's just my favourite one anyway. I just feel like I want to defend it, but I don't want to defend it because I know it's not that good.
Yeah.
All right. It's all wasting my breath, really. But. But I could watch that like over and over, I think.
Yeah, that's why it's on the top 10.
Yeah. And the music, I have to say, that is probably one of the best soundtracks to a film, in my opinion. Hans Zimmer in it. He's amazing.
Yeah.
I listen to the Man of Steel music, like, almost every day.
Religiously.
That's another thing. There's a lot of religious shit in that film, actually. Yeah. He even does the bloody crucifixion pose at one point, doesn't he?
I think so.
Yeah, like, when he goes to save Lois from...
Lois?
Falling down...
Love's lame.
From well, I mean, that's what he does, isn't it? That's all Superman does. But, like, she was in an escape pod or something, wasn't she? She was falling to Earth.
Right Kent, though, isn't he? Really.
Is he right Kent?
Yeah, right Kent.
Let's not get into that. Right, let's move on.
Right, next film.
It's a good film.
Fancy the Egg and all that stuff.
Yes, number three, Scott Pilgrim versus the World. Definitely one of the best films I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not a Edgar Wright one. Yeah, well, it's the third on my list, mate.
Yeah, fine.
It's going to be good, isn't it? I think... that's another film, right? More so than Space Jam. It's a film that I don't think... I think anyone could see it, and no one would say it's bad.
Yeah. It's definitely more
I think everyone could like it.
Yeah, 100%. You could put it on... really give a shit.
Because it's got some romance, it's got a bit of action, it's got a bit of...
soundtrack.
Sci-fi, fantasy, special effects, video game stuff. It's got comedy...
Yeah, oh, it's life.
It's a mix of everything.
It's life.
And it's a balance of everything.
Yeah.
It's Edgar Wright as well. You can't go wrong with Edgar Wright.
It is a very good film.
Definitely. It's probably better than the other two that are on, like, at the top. But, personally, I just think the other one's better. My list is a bit fucked up right now. I think I need to sort it out, but...
That's what I mean, Yeah,
all right. But, Scott Pilgrim, it's a bloody good film. If you haven't seen it, where have you been living?
Yeah.
If you have seen it, good. Donald go watch Trump's it again anyway. Fringe. What's that got to do with anything?
That's where they've been
living. Oh, right, they've been living onto his fringe. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's a big fringe.
Yeah, it is a big fringe. Jesus Christ. He must live in the shade, like, all the time. Like, unless he, like, lays down.
No, it's just the fringe just is his shade.
Yeah.
He just uses that as shade.
He's like, shot outside.
Is that your impression of Trump? Okay, come closer to the microphone and do that again.
No. It's like Tommy Cooper. Oh, yeah.
That is nothing like Trump. It's more like, you gotta pack your lips.
Yeah, alright, I'm not like
that's more like
Donald
Trump
fanatic. Like
he's got huge lips. He's got a huge personality. It's amazing. You love it.
Yeah.
You love me.
We've got a special guest.
Who doesn't love me? Everyone loves me.
Donald Trump is our special guest.
He's on here right now.
Yeah.
He's sitting on right, Donnie? Right. Donnie Trump? How you doing?
Donnie Brasco.
Who?
Oh, God.
No, seriously.
Another film.
Let's not get into that one, Jordan. We still haven't got through the whole list.
All right, yeah.
I don't give a
next
shit.
Film.
Hold on. I haven't done Scott Pilgrim yet. No, I'm done. Okay, so, number two.
Oh.
Right, number two is a bit hard one, right? I like to put three films under this second one, right? I think you know what I'm talking about.
Not really.
Oh.
I don't think so.
Well, I like to put the whole trilogy there because I can't decide on one. But if I had to decide on one... It'd be the third one. Yeah. Well, I'm talking about Toy Story.
Yeah.
I absolutely, without a doubt, love Toy Story. I always have. But It's just, yeah, it's one of those things, you know, it's just like...
Yeah.
It's like, it's stuck with me a lot. Yeah, nostalgic. But difference is, it still holds up.
Yeah.
To this day. Like, I still think it... It's still... In fact, it resonates with me in different ways as I've gotten older. Like, I guess because... I don't know. It's... I just don't think you can ever get old. You can never get old.
You can never get older.
You can never get older. You can never...
Thanks to Benjamin Button.
No matter how old you are, you're going to enjoy that in some way, shape or form.
Yeah.
It's one of
I think, you know, like I said, your granddad would love it, but then your cousin, you know, your three-year-old cousin would love it as well.
Yeah, I think anyone could love Toy Story.
Layers to it as well.
Yeah.
Not really multi-layered.
I think it's quite layered in certain... I think maybe the second and third ones more so.
Yeah.
Than the first, but...
I guess.
I think it's just as good quality as some of the best films ever. Don't you think?
Yeah.
For an animated film as well.
I'm saying it sort of started the rage, didn't it? 95. It started all them animated films.
Yeah, because it's the first, wasn't it?
Exactly. I think everyone sort of looks at Toy Story and then makes an animated film.
3D animated, I should say.
Yeah.
Before anyone goes and no, what about Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs?
Yeah, I guess it's like...
It's 3D animated. It's the first 3D animated feature-length film, right?
Yeah.
Right, but just before we sound like idiots.
Well, I'm going to sound like one anyway, so...
Yeah, but I don't want to sound like an idiot. Right. But,
Yeah.
But, I mean, I really love it. Can you...
Sorry, we found some bubble wrap.
I started bubble wrapping, right.
Bubble wrap.
Right, so the reason I chose the third one to put on the list, because I can't put all three, it doesn't let me... because I'm using an app. Anyways, so the third one I chose because I think it connects to me more because I'm older. And yeah, it's dark. It's a bit more dark. There's a bit more of a deeper message to it near the end as well. And it's more existential, I suppose. Anyway, it's just like because now I'm at the age that Andy is, I guess.
Yeah.
So I feel like I've grown up with him, kind of thing. So it's like it feels like a really good end to the whole thing as well.
Yeah.
I feel like endings are my favourites. I always like endings. I prefer endings to anything else, I think.
Nice.
So, like, I think that's why Worlds End on the Day as well, because it's kind of the end.
Yeah.
You know,
it isn't. It's more the world's end.
Yeah. True.
You saw the word end before.
Fuck. Literally, if you just take away Worlds, it's the end.
Yeah.
Damn, didn't even think about that.
Yeah, fair.
But, and the ending gets me every time.
Fair enough.
Even though I know what's going to happen, it gets me.
Yeah. It's definitely one of them films you can see loads of those times, but when you see it, you don't know what's going to happen.
You do, but you just don't want it to.
You don't.
Do you know what I mean? You're just like, no, you can't give
up. Yeah, but that's the same. It's the same thing as you've seen over so many times, but you still, you know, you forget. You not forget, but you still...
But you're just in it. You're just in there. You're just like, ooh! Don't want to die. Don't want to... Well, I mean, not this...
Don't want to die.
Well, I mean, it's not dying, is it? Because they're doing a fourth one, but...
Yeah, and then a fifth and a sixth and a sixth.
I'm hoping the fourth will be the last, because...
Especially nowadays, because it's a hit formula.
Okay, here's something, right, about the fourth one. Is that, while I think the third is a really great ending, I really like the idea of what they're going to do for the fourth one. I just hope that this is the last one.
Yeah.
For definite, because... The fourth one's got a really great idea. Like, and they did say that... They had the idea, but they were like, we can't just have this as like... Because they have, like, TV shows or specials, don't they?
Yeah.
They have, like, a little special thing every now and then. They're like, we can't just do it like that. It's got to be a proper film.
Yeah.
Something like that, isn't it? I don't know the whole story. I don't, you know, I'm not friends with them. Fair enough. Don't go visit Pixar Studios every day. But, but in case you don't know, do you know what it's about?
Wolf, not really.
No, it's basically... They're trying to find Bo Peep, right?
Right.
Because she disappeared... In between the second and third films.
Yeah.
And Woody and her have a thing.
What do
they? Do you know that? So they're like, well, we're all settled now. We've got a new kid.
Yeah.
And they're like, well, we're missing someone really important. We're missing Bo Peep. So I don't know what it's about exactly, but that's the general idea, is that Woody and Buzz, I'm guessing. Just the two of them? I don't know. That'd be cool if it was just two of them, I think. They go on a bro adventure and they're going to try and find Bo Peep.
It'd be good
story. The way I see what it would happen is that, like, you know, Jesse and Buzz got a good thing going, especially at the end of the third one, they were, like, proper close, you know?
Yeah.
So, like, Spanish Woody would just look at that, and probably Mr. and Mrs. Potato too, And then and maybe even Trixie and Rex, you know, because there's probably a thing going, because they're both dinosaurs, not being racist or anything, but they've got to be together because they're dinosaurs, obviously. Right? Point is, everyone's got someone, but Woody's lost his, you know, his special one, you know?
Yeah.
His Bo Peep.
Oh, yeah.
You're not even fucking listening,
are you? I am listening.
Just looking off at the distance. Looking at random shit. Just like,
I'm listening.
Anyways, Toy Story 4.
It's Toy Story. I don't want to know about Toy Story 4.
I'm going to review it.
They're not even making it yet, are they?
No. I think they've been working on it.
So that, it's not going to be like what 20... you just said. It won't be. Because everyone's going to go be like, oh, yeah, it's about this, and this. And then they're just going to go, oh, no.
Look, if it is,
I'll do something completely different.
If it's not about that, I'm not watching it.
Fair enough.
I don't know, maybe.
But, you know, it's going to be Toy Story. It's a winning formula. Everyone loves Toy Story.
Yeah.
You know.
But I really hope that is the last one, if it ever comes out. If it never comes out, fucking good. But they need to do that story, though.
Yeah,
because Bo Peep got shortchanged.
Shortchanged, right?
She got shortchanged. Next film. Okay, so last film on the list, the first best...
Get my list up.
No. In my opinion, the first and the best film is A Monster Calls, which came out this year as well.
Oh, I've not seen it yet.
Yeah, I think you need to. Like, I don't think I'd ever watch it again, because it's that good. Like, I think I can only watch it once.
Yeah.
Or maybe again, because I don't think I really... No, I don't know.
It's not quite.
Sorry, I had a brain freeze. No, because, like... Right, when in the cinema that I watched it at, right, they had bloody... I don't know if I told you this. I didn't know. They were playing something like really quiet. We could hear like previews or something in the background the whole time. Like, I kept hearing Star Wars noises and stuff. So it kind of ruined the experience a bit. So I probably would watch it again just on my own, just to get the full like proper. So I can really sink it all in. You know, I can really take it all in, and then I'll never watch it again.
Fair enough.
But it's just like. Speaks to me on so many levels, you know.
Yes.
I think it should be on the list, but maybe not the top. I don't know. Because it's like it is amazing, Jordan. It is amazing.
Yeah, no, I'm not saying I should. There probably the be
best.
A top
it 10. Is definitely one of the best films I've ever seen.
Yeah.
But maybe not in terms of film. Just because of what happens, it's because of the events that happen in it and stuff.
Yeah.
But they do it, and it's really clever. And I'd like to read the book actually.
Yeah.
Because it was. I mean, everything's based on the book.
That's what the film should be, yeah. Should lead on to the book. Is alright?
But yeah, I think you should see it, definitely. Oh. Right, we've been going for almost an hour now.
Good. I haven't told my films yet.
We're just going to skim through that.
We're not. No, I will skim through it. It's a few... Like I say,
it took
me,
us like half an hour to get through mine, so...
Yeah, and yours is only 10. Mine's like 30 odd. Yeah, but
okay, I'll find your list.
Invisible Man, 1933.
Yeah.
James Whale directed. Obviously, it's an adaptation from H.G. Wells' book.
Mm-hmm.
It's funny, it's cruel, it's wicked. It's a social commentary film for me. It's just, you know, it's just a wonderful film.
Mm.
You know, about, you know, this man who wants
who's invisible?
Power. Have you seen it?
just a lucky guess.
Just a guess.
Lucky guess.
But just this man who wants, I don't know, goes a bit power crazy, I suppose, thinks he's on something. And I guess we all do want to find out something that makes us special or, you know, whatever like that, you know, socially accepted.
Mm.
But then he isn't really, and everyone doesn't want him because he's invisible and he's causing chaos.
They think he's mental.
Yeah.
But he ends up going mental.
But everyone still wants to know who he is. And this is mental. And obviously, you know, the scene, I'm going to, not, this doesn't ruin it, but there's a scene in it where everyone's panicking and this speaks a lot to me, this scene. Everyone's panicking and they lock the doors. Everyone's locking doors and there's bolts and that. And then there's the invisible man just asleep in the bed.
Yeah.
And then there's other people locking doors and bolts going and then he's still sleeping in the bed. I just think it's just like such, you know, a social commentary, and it's like, why are we worried about this thing that's not really doing anything?
Yeah.
Like, you know, a lot of people are worried about stupid things. You know, I love that film. That's pretty, you know, in my film. You know. But, yeah.
Right.
The Martins as well.
Yeah, I was about to say that one.
I love the Martins.
So I've got the list now.
Lee Evans, Kathy Burke, Mark Strong's in that as well somewhere along the line.
Is he?
You know, a little Bob.
Oh, yeah.
He's a neighbour, isn't he, across the fence?
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
Our right to buy, where's our right to sell? It's great. I love that film. That is so heartwarming.
I know you like it, but I don't.
You saw it, you didn't like it.
No.
Why did you not like it?
Because it's just cringy.
It's not cringy. Oh, I love it.
It makes me really cringe.
You know, he's this idiot. He's this twat.
Exactly.
He's... And then, but then at the end of the film, he delivers... No, spoilers alert. You gone?
Spoilers! Yeah. Okay, we're good.
You know, and delivers the baby, and everyone loves him. And this is that really, you know... He can do no wrong, really. It's Lee Evans. Brilliant.
Yeah, I do. I love Lee Evans, but... just doesn't that do, film, doesn't do just, it for me.
Yeah. When he gets a football in the face, little Bob gets a football in the face. He's like, you got to stand up and be a man. There's fucking football in his face. Poor sod.
I would just want to say, I would recommend you see it.
Because it's a brilliant film, I love it.
I just don't like it.
It's brilliant. And obviously, Quentin Tarantino films. But I won't go into that, it'd be a different separate podcast.
Like Death Proof, for instance.
I love Death Proof. I don't know why, but it's got me my favourite. If I'd say... Are you not seen no Tarantino films? Oh, you got to watch Death... I wouldn't say watch Death Proof first.
Right.
But for me, I love that one because I love cars. I love that. That genre of sort of bullet, you know, French Connection, the car chase stuff of the sort of 70s, 80s. Right. You know, Vanishing Point. I love that. And the people, you know, Zoe Bell in it. Absolutely, I love her. She's brilliant. Obviously, Tarantino stunt woman. They did Kill Bill, but she went on to star in that film.
I didn't know Rosario Dawson's in it.
Yeah.
Do you know her?
No.
You don't know her?
What's she in?
She's in Death Proof.
Yeah, obviously. What else is she in?
Oh, she's in all the Netflix Marvel shows at the moment. She's she's in all of them. Like, she's a nurse. She like nurses them all, basically.
Yeah, fine. Netflix is shit, so.
Anyway, well, let's not get into that. So.
Quentin Tarantino, yeah.
Yeah, sorry.
You know, obviously, Reservoir Dogs I love because probably the first one. You know, it's probably one of my earliest memories of film is Reservoir Dogs.
Mm.
You know, obviously, Pulp Fiction. Everyone knows Pulp Fiction, brilliant film. You know, the characters. I love Hateful Eight. A lot of people,
I love Hateful Eight too. Yeah.
Yeah, well, my uncle don't like it, but I think that's just a wonderful film. You know, it's got a bit of Cronenberg in it. It's got a bit of Agatha Christie. It's got a bit of everything in that.
Mm.
Literally everything you can think of is in that film. You know, obviously great actors as well as Donoghue. What's the actress called?
What?
The actress.
In what?
Plays the woman.
In what, sorry?
Hateful Eight.
I got confused. Oh, her.
I love her. She's in Machinist. She's a brilliant actress.
Oh, shit. Hold on, I'll Google it.
Obviously got the normal cast. Shame about Channing Tatum's in it, aren't you?
Channing Tatum?
Yeah.
He's good there.
He's good in that, but I don't like him as an actor person. But he was good in that because he's not in it a lot and he gets his head blown off.
Jennifer Jason Leigh.
Yeah, she's absolutely amazing. And she's in The Machinist, like I say.
Tim Roth is in it as well.
Yeah. That's a normal car, normal Tarantino.
I thought that was...
Mulberry.
Yeah, I thought it was... what's his name? Christoph Waltz. I thought that was him the whole time.
Christoph Waltz is brilliant, though.
Yeah, he is good.
He's absolutely... Amazing.
No, of course he is.
See Big Eyes again. Yeah, seen that. Watch. No. He's not actually good in that, but I like his on the eyes, but yeah.
This is England.
I love English singers, because as I, you know, a lot, I was getting into that scene, not really getting into it, but I love that scene of the skinhead stuff, and when people say skinhead, a lot of people think National Front, and, you know, beating up black people, racism, and, you know, I don't like Pakistanis and stuff like that, and that film really does show two sides of, you know, the scar scene comes from reggae. Reggae comes from black people. Most of the skinheads were black.
Mm.
And a lot of people think, racist. You know, the first hour of that film, or the first part of that film is, you know, a kid getting into that scene of a lovable family who loves music, who loves a good time, and just love everyone. I want to be united, and everyone should be united. And the second half with Stephen Graham, and it was a brilliant actor, is the racial side and how... You know, Stephen Graham beats Milky up. Spoilers alert, sorry. But he hates black people. And that's what skinheads aren't. And it's a two-sided coin to... And how Shane Meadows, brilliant director, and how he wanted to show the two sides to it and show the audience there is two sides to skinheads. Not all skinheads just to wear, you know, size 9 boots and kick the shit out of black people. You know, they are actually black. Most of them aren't. I just think that's brilliant.
Right.
And he spoke to me as a kid.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay. Say. Hello.
Hello.
Goodbye.
Aha!
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
On the first episode.
Yeah. First podcast.
Yeah.
Episode podcast.
Should have a name.
Should
by
have
the
name.
Time it comes out.
It won't.
What, we're just gonna call it Untitled.
I was in a one man band once. We split up for musical differences. Anyway, yeah.
Well, so, one hand was doing one thing, one hand was doing the other. Yeah.
Yeah, the foot didn't like the hand. And
slapped your foot.
Divorced.
And then he went pizza on
you. Yeah, right, same. Right.
Well, yeah, Oi. You don't know. You don't know what he just did there. Flipped off the microphone. Don't know why he did that. I mean, the microphone's just recording it, mate. Stop fucking clicking it.
What?
For God's sake.
Carl, that was a mute button on the thing. It's brilliant.
I'm going to have to turn it back
around.
It turns
red when it does it.
It's brilliant. Ooh, it turns red. Do you know what else does that traffic light? Just go and play it.
I know. That hurt.
That was a funny one.
That hurt me.
I'm so funny. Sorry, anyways. What was I going to say? You fucked me up. I'm trying to a proper, like, professional outro.
It's just a YouTube podcast,
not really. Hey guys, well, thanks for watching our YouTube podcast. The best podcast in the world. Well, we're gonna do more of this. We'll probably just talk more films, which is
It's the whole idea of the podcast.
We haven't done a lot of that today, but we'll do more.
Talk about film knowledge in general.
I'd rather, like, I know we talked about a lot of shit. I feel like we've I feel like for this episode we talked about loads of things, right? And I'm thinking for the next time we'll just try and keep
If you've got any films,
don't want to confuse people. So
if there's any films you want us to review or to watch or to say something about, or series, director, whatever.
It could be TV series as well.
Whatever, whatever.
TV's quite good these
moving
days.
Moving images, mate. Moving images.
That's just anything that moves.
Not flicker books, I can't do that.
No,
I've got pen around flicker books.
Motion comics, appreciate.
Yeah.
Depends which one. If you have a good one, if there is one, if you've made one.
Just say, if there's anything you disagree, send a carrier pigeon. It's easier.
Yeah, just tell us how stupid we are.
Yeah.
How nerdy we are.
How many people are pissed off.
Tell us how much we haven't had sex, possibly. Well.
Yeah, how many times we stayed in late to watch films.
Yeah, rather than.
I watched 4 films earlier.
I'm definitely cutting out. Can't say that word.
My trousers are like 10 centimetres above my waist, and my socks are showing. And I've got greasy hair.
Greasy?
Yeah.
Don't want to talk about.
We finished the podcast now, haven't we?
No, we haven't finished yet. We're officially, this is the end now. Okay? Stop fucking moving, I'm trying to finish it.
Sorry.
Just stay still for a second, right?
Yeah, go.
So, check out Daisy Chain Films for more content. We're going to make more podcasts in the future.
We have to start watch doing this space.
We're going to do it like really fast, so it's like a minute long, so you can listen to the whole thing.
Yeah, we're
going
to speed it up.
And it doesn't impact your day.
It shouldn't bore you either.
Doesn't disrupt your day, is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah. Listen to it when you sleep.
Yeah, listen to it when you sleep. This is ASMR, one of those.
You probably will go to sleep halfway through anyway, but they're going to be bored.
Basically. I mean, we're going to make
it. Especially now, anyway. We're going on. We said goodbye about 10 minutes ago.
The aim of this podcast is to make people fall asleep. So, with that in mind, we're going to go sleep ourselves. It's only 2 o'clock in the afternoon. But we're all pretty knackered now.
Yeah, I've got some more films to watch.
Yeah, we've got.
Some more films I want downtown.
I'm going to have to go watch The Shining and Clubbed, probably.
You've got to see Clubbed. We'll bring it around and 10 Cloverfield Lane.
Oh yeah, 10 Cloverfield Lane, even though that's completely unrelated to what we've been talking about.
Yeah, but we will talk about it.
But we will talk about everything. We're going to talk about every film. The aim is to talk about and watch every single film ever made.
Yeah.
Apart from Green Lantern.
Yeah, or Metamorphosis, because that's quite long.
Metamorphosis?
What?
Jordan, this isn't related to what we've been talking about.
Yeah, that's a really long film. It's like 1921.
I've never heard of it. How long is it?
It's like 3 hours, isn't it? What's the longest film? Andy Warhol, 6 hours.
Hours long?
I think so. It's just some blokes just sleeping in.
That's not a film.
Well, yeah, it's an art film. It's still a film.
No. I refuse to accept that is a film.
It is a film.
Nothing happens in it. He's sleeping, that's it.
Yeah, but he's obviously dreaming. So obviously, you just said it yourself. Like, he's sleeping, so obviously something's happening.
Yeah, but nothing else happens.
Yeah. Anyway.
That's stupid. But anyways, I'm trying to think what else we've got to say. Is there anything else to say?
No.
Just subscribe to Daisy Chain Films. Subscribe to Jordan Lewington. That's this guy's name. I forgot we haven't even introduced ourselves. Right, let's do the intro. Introduce ourselves right now. Hi, guys. Welcome to... He's going to cough. Okay.
Don't try hard coping, whatever you do.
No, so, right, let me fucking... Because we got to introduce ourselves. I'm going to put this at the start, right? Ready?
Right,
he keeps trying to interrupt me.
I'm not low.
Hi, guys. Welcome to whatever this podcast is called. My name's Louis. I'm your host. And with me is my co-host...
Jordan.
Jordan Langton.
If you can decode that, put a postcard, I'd be very happy.
Decode it?
Yeah, because I couldn't understand what I just said.
Oh. I'll just fucking end it. See you later, guys.
So quiet yourself and stop that fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. And kindly point that gun the other way and hobble, hobble, hobble off and dip to hey, hey. Hey, boss man, what do you say? It's easy pickings. There ain't nobody here but us chickens.